Recently, I said in one of my videos that DC was void of the Holy Spirit and was dead. Then I was sent this link today from DC Superhero, who has been DC's oldest comic superhero since 1940. They made him gay and revived him to his youth. The creator said, "We should be preaching love and tolerance." Now, this picture that you're looking at is my rendition of this cartoon. Do you see or notice in this picture that there are skulls in it? I wonder if many of you even know what skull worship is. Oh, it's in order to establish connection to the spirit world. What has that got to do with the superhero? Well, it's calling up and open up portals. You can make the connection. Do all of you out there really know what's going on? Sometimes I gotta scratch my head and wonder. Make the connection. Orlando is known as Magic Kink-dom. People's been asking me, why? Why would God want to sink Florida? It's so beautiful, wonderful down there. I've been there on vacation. I have friends and family that live there, and they love it. Well, Orlando is known as Kingpin or Porn Capital. Yep, that's right. Florida is also one of the most scandalous states in the nation, next to Las Vegas. It's number two. People flee while you still can from these areas. These three areas are judgment will soon fall. And when it falls, it's going to fall hard. Run. Run as fast as you can. Don't look back. That's not the only ones, but that's the only ones I'm talking about right now. Jesus, who? Actor says Pitt and Clooney are bigger than Jesus. If we walked Jesus, Brad Pitt, George Clooney down Fifth Avenue, I think Clooney and Brad Pitt would get more attention, says Steve Gutenberg. Pretty arrogant statement, you think? Listen, I'm nobody. I'm sure if George Clooney was there, she'd have a heart attack. But the great thing about being famous is it's a new religion. Jesus is not a big name anymore. The big names are Brad and Angelina. And that's just the way it is. And if we walked Jesus and Brad Pitt and George Clooney down Fifth Avenue, I just think that Clooney and Pitt would get a whole lot more attention. Sickening, people. This is just sickening and pure arrogance. This tells you what times we're in. Now, I've been hearing another old song. I'm not singing for you this time. It goes, "Does anyone really know what time it is?" You know, it was talking about the times, not talking about the times of Jesus Christ. Nothing to do with him. It's talking about Antichrist. Just like this stupid man here. They're calling forth a person that they think is going to make this world better. Oh, this person that they're calling forth is going to make slaves of the whole world. They're actually talking about the person at that book, The Science of Christ, was talking about, that I had the interview with my friend Tom. Because we're all brainwashed. All the Hollywood people, all the rock and roll people, most of our Congress, senators, all the world leaders, all the voodoo, hoodoo, all those people are calling forth the Antichrist. And you notice that this Steven Spielberg called Christ she. What a disgrace. Next. On the very day that Obama supported the same-sex marriage, a group of students announced to an evangelical Christian college in California, "We want to bring to light the presence of TQ community at Biola, despite what some assume there are lesbians, gays, bisexuals, transgenders, and queers at Biola. We are Biola students, alumni, employees, and fellow followers of Christ." I beg to differ with, and you cannot be followers of Christ and be any of those. But let me go on. "We want to be treated as equally and respected as another facet of biodiversity." And I think that should be university, but I'm reading from the paper here. And they stated they would all come out in due time and felt that they were all Christians, knowing that if and when they come out, they will be expelled, probably fired, too. I also recently made a video on homosexual Bible, if you've watched that, and put it out there that it was going to be in your face, and you would be forced to accept it in your churches, or the doors would be closed. Well, here it is. All planned out for you in your face. Believe it or not, America, you are being judged, and America will fail, because it is being forced on you right here. Because they will probably force this Christian university that has been a university, Christian beliefs, for 105 years to accept them as part of their curriculum, or it will be fined and closed, just like your churches will be. This is their goal. Accept it. It's coming. How can all this happen while war's going on? Well, think about during Hitler's time, all the things that happened in Hitler. They were during all that crazy stuff going on while they were at war too. It'll happen. It's coming. It's all spirits. Demonic spirits. While they're worshiping skulls, calling forth more opening of portals, homosexual spirits, demonic spirits, running wild around the world. Seek God's face. Seek Him. He is the only answer. Bisexuals, transgenders, queers, whatever you want to call yourself, lesbians, gays, you are not Christians. You may be a Muslim Christian, but you are not a Christian of Yahweh God. He is not your father. You are not going to heaven. You fooled yourself. You are brainwashed. You were not born that way, because you are not following the ways of the Father. You were not born that way because He says that it is an abomination. It is a stench in His nose. I know this is strong, but it's true. Makes you mad because it's a spirit inside of you making you angry. It's against that spirit. It needs cast out of you. Seek God and know the truth. His ways are higher than our ways. His thoughts are higher than our thoughts. He says, read my word to wash your mind, to get your thoughts out and put His in. He loves you. I don't hate anyone. God loves you too. He loves us all, no matter what we've done. Seek Him. Call Him out. says, turn from your wicked ways and come to me, and I will heal you. Thank you, Lord.